I'm Megan Darwish with TV Insider, and I'm speaking with Leslie Manville about season 5 of The Crown.
I denied you as queen, not as your sister.
The conditions are irrelevant. The prohibition is what counts. A prohibition, incidentally, you are not now extending to Anne.
That is different.
How is it different? Anne is a royal princess with no prospect of acceding to the throne, as was I.
Well, first off, congrats on season 5. Margaret has some great moments this season, particularly when she gets to reunite with Peter Townsend, who is played by the iconic Timothy Dalton. What was it like getting to rekindle their romance on screen, because we haven't seen those characters together in so long?
Yes, well, I mean, obviously, I wasn't playing Margaret when they were initially together, so I could only observe that from the previous seasons and, you know, read about it, which I did. It felt very right. I think Timothy was extremely good casting, and you know they're not going to get together again. You know, he's married and she's in a different place in her life. They're grown up. They've had 40 years sort of between their last meeting. But it's very beautifully written. So and they get to dance together, and you can just see the heat that was obviously there in their relationship and their passion. But it's very beautiful and rather sweet. You just see them looking into each other's eyes, and you know that whole history and fondness and love and memory of those heady times that they had are all still there. So in a way, those scenes are so well written. You know, we just had to play them because the audience is doing it all. The audience knows what they've been through, knows their history. And I think the little flashbacks occasionally to Vanessa Kirby walking into his office and then just jumping on him and kissing him, you know, you just kind of, it's so lovely to just see that, even as a fleeting moment, you know, alongside where they are now, you know, this older couple in a very different time of their lives, but still just remembering what they meant to each other. It's all done very beautifully, I think.
It is very beautiful. And Peter says to her, he needed to find out whether their love was a fleeting love or if it was a lasting love. And they do get to share this sweet kiss. For her, is it a lasting love, or is that the sadness of it all, is that she never really got to find out if it would be?
Well, you've only got a few minutes. In brief, I think our drama, The Crown, takes the story that she never fully recovered from that, and that it is this great love that was lost. I'm not so sure about the reality of that, but that's a much longer conversation and we'd need half an hour. But in all my readings and understandings of everything, I think as a very, very, very young woman who was rather infatuated with this older man, when they had this forced separation of a couple of years, I think in essence, she sort of got over it and moved on. But we are a drama and we are not adhering in any kind of ardent way to the actual facts, because in a way we don't know that. That's what I've just gleaned from what I've read, and that's my take on it. But obviously in our drama world we can do what we want, so we are playing it that, you know, it's very heartbreaking for her and he is the man that got away and shouldn't have.
And on a last note, obviously you know, Margaret sees a connection in herself with Diana because of her spark, and it's sad to see that extinguished. Does she see herself as an ally, do you think, or is that the approach you took in your you know, take on Margaret, or is she just an observer?
I think she was an ally because she did, you know, that the amount of press interest in Diana was very much what Margaret had gone through in her youth. I think she was one of the most written about and photographed women in the world. in her youth. So she absolutely understands that and understands the pressures. But I think her feelings about Diana shift when it becomes clear that she's not quite the ally to the royal family as she... everyone hoped.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Leslie.
You can watch The Crown now on Netflix. And for more videos like this, subscribe to TV Insider.